Many new growers are undecided between aquaponics and hydroponics. Aquaponics entices you with the allure of living organisms, while hydroponics entices you with its precision and power. There are several facts and viewpoints available. Unfortunately, many of them use generalizations and blanket words to rate different types of growing. In this video, we will conduct an unbiased comparison of the two strategies. We've summarized all of the advantages and drawbacks of both strategies, but before we get into the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on so you don't miss any of the new videos we post. What is hydroponics? Hydroponics is a common method for growing plants that relies solely on chemical nutrients and water. Plants are grown without the use of soil. This is the most popular method for growing basil, lettuce, and tomatoes in the United States. Although there are many advantages of using hydroponics to grow plants, it is most widely used because the results are consistent and have the ability to produce high yields. Hydroponics involves growing plants in a nutrient-rich water-based solution. The plant's roots are suspended directly in the nutrient-rich water, giving them direct access to the nutrients they need to grow. At the same time, the remaining plants would have access to oxygen, allowing the growth process to proceed without interruption. There are various types of hydroponic systems. Many of these alter how the water flows and how it reaches the plants. What is aquaponics? Aquaponics is a growing method that involves growing fish and plants in the same space. The waste from the fishes is converted directly into nitrates by the bacteria in the surrounding area when using this growing process. These nitrates are used as plant food until the remaining water is returned to the fishes and is free of harmful pollutants. This creates a very effective and efficient growth cycle that is most commonly referred to as the nitrogen cycle. Although the waste ultimately becomes harmful to the fish in the tank, the bacteria added to the water turns the waste into beneficial nitrates before any of the fish are harmed. Although the aquaponics farming and growing method is easy, there are a variety of systems that can be used with it, which include everything from vertical towers and media beds to the nutrient film technique. The primary differences between the two. Despite the fact that both hydroponics and aquaponics are highly successful plant growing methods, there are some key differences between the two that you should be aware of before deciding which is the better choice for you. Since both of these approaches are capable of growing plants without the use of soil, they can be useful to you if you choose to stop using soil. However, you will need to devote time to learning about the approach you choose, which is why understanding the discrepancies between the two is critical. Retain nutrient solution. Although hydroponic systems need a high concentration of nutrients in the water, the systems may often accumulate too many salts and chemicals, making the water toxic to the plants. As a result, the water must be disposed of on a regular basis. The nitrogen balance in the water in an aquaponic system is fine, so the water should never need to be changed. Productivity. When compared to a hydroponics method, after an aquaponics garden is completely operational, which takes about 6 months, the plant growth results should be slightly more effective and faster. Cost of chemical nutrient. Chemical nutrients are needed in hydroponic systems, which can be very expensive. These nutrients have also become scarce in recent years, driving up prices even more. The fish feed used in an aquaponic system, on the other hand, is much less expensive. Organic growth. A hydroponic system's atmosphere is created by humans. Aquaponics is an ecological system because it is intended to mimic a completely natural environment. A hydroponic system's nutrients can include a variety of salts and chemicals, which isn't good for the environment. Plant food in aquaponics comes from a natural conversion of fish waste, which allows for this organic growth to occur. Ease of maintenance. The maintenance of an aquaponic system is minimal. In a hydroponic environment, however, the electrical conductivity of the water must be tested on a regular basis. The water chemistry would remain relatively stable due to the normal ecosystem of development that occurs in an aquaponics environment. Ammonia and pH levels, as well as nitrate levels, would only need to be tested once a week, along with nitrate levels on a monthly basis. Pesticides. While insects are less of a problem in these systems due to the lack of soil, some insects such as thrips and spider mites can still make a nuisance and must be dealt with. To get rid of these insects in a hydroponic system, you may need to use pesticides. Aquaponic systems, on the other hand, necessitate non-chemical approaches to ensure that the fish are not harmed. pH. pH is an essential component of any water-based growth process. When using a hydroponic method, the water pH should be between 5.5 and 6.0, which is slightly acidic. The pH pH level in an aquaponic system, on the other hand, should be about 6.8 to 7.0, which is considered neutral. Similarities between the two. Growing season. When opposed to conventional growing methods, both of these systems are known for having long growing seasons. Since these systems are usually installed indoors, you'll be able to grow plants all year, which means you'll be able to grow some produce even during the off-season. Lessened negative environmental impacts. Since plants are grown in aquaponic and hydroponic systems indoors, there are few weed and pest problems to contend with. Since these devices seldom have to deal with such issues, you won't need to use as many chemicals in your glass house, lowering the risk of negative environmental consequences. Faster growth. These plants can grow 30 to 50% faster than their conventional soil-based counterparts since they are grown in systems that do not use soil. Since the plants have more oxygen, they're able to expand at a faster rate. Root growth and nutrient absorption are supported by the added oxygen. Higher yields. Plants grown in hydroponic or aquaponic systems usually produce 30 to 40% more plants grown in other ways. Reduced insect pressure and plants receiving higher quantities of food on a regular basis result in higher yields. Top advantages of hydroponics. Perfect for small spaces. Although there are a variety of hydroponic kits on the market, once you understand the fundamentals of this technology, you can easily create your own garden to match even that odd corner of your bathroom that has been vacant for years. Since the 1970s, hydroponics has been used to develop plants in space due to its versatility and suitability for all conditions. On the International Space Station, there is now a completely functional hydroponic glass house. They yield much higher crops. When hydroponics, developed by Dr. William Frederick Garrick in 1929, was first introduced, it became clear that plants grown in this manner were larger and yielded better and larger crops than those grown in traditional soil. When word got out that he had developed a method for growing plants in water, the scientific community did what it does best, dismissed it. So, at the University of California, he grew a 25-foot-tall tomato plant to show his colleagues that not only could he grow plants without soil, but that they were also larger, faster growing, and produced more fruits than conventionally grown plants. To be frank, there is now a way to equal the yield of hydroponics using aquaponics, but it necessitates a complex double-cycle water system. You have full control over the growth of your plants. There are no external influences in hydroponics, such as the weather, the fish's health, or even their appetite. You know how much water, nutrient solution, and how much you can send it to your plants. You have complete control over the growth of your plants and the production of food. Top advantages of aquaponics. Greater selling factor. It has a strong selling point. Consider the most idyllic scenario. You want to establish a pick-your-own farm where families can come to harvest their own food. Can you imagine the kids laughing and admiring your fish ponds as the parents go alternative shopping and ask you lots of questions about your little farm? Imagine how many beautiful pictures you might use on flyers to promote your small business if you closed your eyes. You can probably see why aquaponics is so common. Great educational tool. It's a fantastic way to teach children about nature, and not just your own. You can also use your aquaponic garden to teach biology to your neighbor's children, and on a larger scale, to school children. Potential to offer solutions. In the big picture, aquaponics could help with large-scale farming, as well as restoring degraded areas, relaunching tourism, and rebalancing the environment. It's the stuff of futuristic fantasies, perfect for nature lovers. Aquaponics can be a wonderful hobby if you enjoy being outside and have a passion for biology. Yes, aquaponics is more complicated than hydroponics, but if you want to see Mother Nature at work in your backyard, it might be the way to go. So that leaves the question, which is better? Well, we will leave that up to you now that you know all the facts, but they are both great ways of growing plants without the use of soil, and both have their advantages and disadvantages. If you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to like and subscribe so you never miss out on any of our new and upcoming content. Thanks for watching.